the same time, O'Keefe is a lobbyist for ExxonMobil. He's also at
When I was at Greenpeace, we started to look into who was funding these think tanks. And you started to find ExxonMobil and the Koch brothers and the Southern Company.
ExxonMobil has been a major funder of climate change disinformation. They funded over 30 different organizations that promoted disinformation or misleading information about the issue of climate change.
Once we got reporters...
Nobody's going to believe ExxonMobil. But if they can say it through somebody else who seems independent, then there's power in that for them.
Myron Ebell is Director of Energy and Global Warming Policy for the Competitive Enterprise Institute.
He's Senior Fellow and Science Director of the Heartland Institute.
The idea that cooling...
It creates a whole new cast of characters, these people who become well-known for casting doubt on global warming.
Dr. Marlo Lewis, a Senior Fellow at the Competitive...
What these institutes then do is they promote their own experts as contrary experts who can give you the other side of the issue. And journalists fall for it. They fall for it lock, stock, and barrel.
Let's talk to a couple of experts, shall we? Joining us now from...
Scientists will be invited to explain the science. And then, against the scientists, they will have a so-called expert from a think tank. And so the public is presented with dueling experts.
Stephen Zebiak is General Director of International Research Institute in Climate and Society at Columbia University. James Taylor is a Senior Fellow at the Conservative Heartland Institute, the group.
But if you actually ask what are their credentials, the answer is often very little and sometimes none.
When I was in college, I majored in government. I also took several atmospheric science courses. I also took several economics courses. I think that makes me pretty well positioned to bring together all the aspects of this debate because it's scientific, it's economic, it's political.
There are think tanks that do nothing but crank out op-ed pieces every day. If you actually start tracking them, you'll see it's the same handful of people that just keep pumping out this material.
Some of these so-called experts, they become go-to people. A handful of them turn out to be very, very good at it.
The global warming alarm spread by Al Gore and the United Nations is in utter scientific collapse. We've gone 16 years without global warming, according to the UN data. This is now akin to medieval witchcraft, where we used to blame witches for controlling the weather.